The Earth is known as a watery planet. That's because 71% of the planet's surface is covered in water. Water is found in oceans, bays, and seas, in permanent snow, ice caps, and glaciers. We also have groundwater and fresh water. All in all, the Earth holds more than 326 million trillion gallons of water. But here's the thing. Despite this abundance of water all around us, there is still a lot about this liquid that is somehow a mystery to many of us. Chief among them are two basic questions. Is water wet? And why does it make us wet? As usual, we have found the answers for you. But before that, please don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to our channel. It will inspire us even more to create these fun and informative videos just for you. Now, to answer the first question, water being wet depends on how we define wet or wetness. If wet refers to a condition wherein a liquid sticks to a solid surface, for example, water sticking to our skin, then that would mean water can't be wet by itself. It needs to have a solid object to stick to for us to have that condition of wetness. Now, if wet means that feeling we get when our skin gets in contact with a liquid, then that would mean water is wet. Additionally, if by wet, we mean something that is made of moisture or liquid, then definitely water is wet, and so is any liquid for that matter. Experts and common people alike are yet to agree on a single definition of the word wet, and so the arguments will continue. Regarding our second question, why water makes objects wet? There seems to be a consensus already that it's because water molecules stick to the surface of solid objects, such as our skin. For any liquid, two forces are constantly trying to overcome each other. On the one hand, we have cohesive or attractive forces that try to keep the molecules stuck to each other. These are the same forces that create surface tension, which is why bubbles form. Liquids that have stronger cohesive forces won't spread out much on the surface of solid objects. Mercury, which is a metallic element in liquid form, is an example of such a liquid. On the other hand, there are adhesive forces that cause the liquid molecules to stick to the surface of an object, spreading them out. This is what happens when we soak something in water, or when we take a bath or wash our hands. Actually, water has stronger cohesive forces compared to alcohols or acetone, so it doesn't wet surfaces as much as the other two. When we use detergents or soap, that lessens the cohesive forces in water, allowing it to be more effective at wetting objects. So that's why water makes us wet. Believe it or not, our skin doesn't have a receptor that can sense wetness. Experts think our sense of being wet does not come from the actual feeling, but more of a perceptual illusion. Our brain tells us something is wet because of prior experiences involving stimuli that we have come to know as wet. What we have instead are sensory receptors that can differentiate between hot and cold temperatures, as well as pressure and texture. When we dip our hands in water, those receptors send information to our brain about the sensation water brings. Retrieving similar experiences from our memory, the brain then interprets that it's wetness that we are feeling. And, for that matter, water is wet. But it's more like saying fire is hot or that wood is hard. We hope you have found this latest episode of Aha, so that's why quite informative. Let us know what you think in the comment section. Please don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.